Let's write a bleak tale of murder, a crime novel set in Scandinavia. Give us a gloomy anti-hero given to some antisocial behaviour. Our central character, Sven or Lars, is often depressed in low-down bars. He smokes, he drinks, he likes Sibelius. He's haunted by his abject failures. Oh, when writing your novel, all you need to know is it's just Raymond Chandler with a lot more snow. To write a good book, the first in a thrilling series, a stiff is found in Stockholm, near the Irish pub O'Leary's. The cadaver is that of Kirsten, a dancer in Mamma Mia. She's been horribly branded with names of the furniture ranges from IKEA. Wahrlich, Bester, Benny. Our man drives to the scene in his Volvo, being careful not to speed. And though it delays him, he buckles his seatbelt because he's a boring Swede. He tracks his suspect to Malmo whilst an endless deluge of sleet falls. Meanwhile, in a processing factory, more bodies are found in a vat of meatballs. A noisy shootout leaves our protagonist temporarily deaf. And book one ends when he works out the killer must be the Muppet Chef. Oh, it was me, Swedish Chef. I did it with my Mullinex magic maker and my slotted spoon. Woo-hoo-hoo.
Woo-hoo, how exciting. Now I can't wait for book two.
Oh, you'll have to wait for book two. I use my Breville sandwich toaster.
Woo-hoo.
And an oven mitt. It gets very messy. Oh, all the cheese and body. Oh.
It's really unfair. They haven't done that before.
Let's write a fun girly novel, the kind that sports a pastel cover, set in a world where a good career is just as vital as a lover. Bestriding the world in 6-inch heels, our heroine does multi-million deals. She's hip and clever, smart and urban, and finds the sight of sheep disturbing. Oh, she'll never need to wed or cohabit, 'cause in her Hermes bag is her rampant rabbit. To write a good book, a shining example of chick lit, begin with a fashion editor who drives her Audi to quick fit. She's immediately attracted to a man in a red Lamborghini, but of course she assumes he only drives it because his penis is weenie. At a business lunch at the Ivy, she wears Azadeen a liar. In the lady, she pops in some Chinese balls, which set her twat on fire. Then she rushes off to a photo shoot at the latest Jill Sander collection, which is taking place in an abattoir to set off the clothes to perfection. After shopping at La Perla, it's time to pick her Audi up. And she's nicely surprised when the handsome mechanic drinks from her fuzzy cup. Let's write a celebrity biog about your rise to national stardom. How you grew up in Romford, Essex, a dead-end life that you have come so far from. Your fledgling career took an upward shunt when you won actual money on bargain hunt. You've a Chinese symbol tattooed on your wrist. You think it says peace, but it really says pissed. Oh, include lots of shots of you in skimpy clothes. It'll obviate the need to write too much prose.
To write a good book, and the first book's only a taster. Your mum was a one-legged lesbian who conceived with a turkey baster. You knew that destiny'd singled you out, a dancer, maybe a singer, and ignored all those jeering Jezebels who called you a slaggy old minger.
Slaggy old minger!
Shut up! You won the heart of the nation in a reality show about slappers. Were captured on film with Ashley Cole being sausage like the clappers. Then you had your boobs implanted, had them removed, then wished you'd kept them. Told the surgeon to give you Britney's nose when he had to rebuild your septum. And now you stand to make millions. Well, the tabloids have gone mad, 'cause hubby number three turns out is your biological dad.
Though with the likes of Dostoevsky, you'll surely never rank. Sell the movie rights and laugh all the way to the bank.